Hey guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So I'm starting the vlog at night because of course you'll have already seen by the title, but I am traveling and I'm going on a trip with my parents and I'm leaving tomorrow in the morning. I'll tell you all the location and all the details tomorrow, but I'm leaving tomorrow like very 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 early in the morning, so depending on that I have to be at the airport. I don't know if I have to wake up at 3 or 4, but nonetheless I'll see you all in the morning and I'll tell you all what time I wake up and where we're going and all the details. But I thought of starting the vlog the night before in case, you know, I'm in a hurry tomorrow and I just have to leave fast. And I've already made like a proper pack with me travel video, how I pack, some tips, etc. So I'll link that video in the description. So I'm not going to show all the packing process right now because I've already done that. We've already been there, done that. You all know it. But this trip is going to be a short trip, a 3-day trip, because it's okay, wait, let me tell you all the details tomorrow at the airport or when I'm in the car. But for now, I'm watching Lapata Ladies. It's getting a lot of popularity. Now all my friends are watching it and they're like, it's a really good movie. I'm done with like 34 minutes. It's not a very long movie. I'm not typically someone that goes for genres like these. I feel like my taste in movies is a little different. So let me watch it and see how it is. I finished watching the movie, so I just wanted to give you all a quick review. Oh my God, it was so wholesome. The movie in itself was a little slow, I would say, but the meaning and the message that it conveys, just the ending, I feel like the last bit of it was the most engaging for me. Through and through it was fine, but the meaning, the story behind it makes it a worth watch. And you just feel so good in the end. Both people get what they want and that's what the movie is about. So you all should watch Lapata Ladies. It's on Netflix. So it is the next morning now and it's the morning of the trip. It's 4 a.m. in the morning, and maybe by the way that I look, it does not look like it's 4 a.m. because I look relatively fresh. Of course, on the day of the trip, whatever time you get up, yeah, you're fresh only. But no, it's not like that. I'm obviously a little sleepy because I've hardly slept. So maybe I'll feel sleepy on the flight or a little later in the car because I slept at 12. Like, I don't know, I was just not getting sleep. And especially, you know, when there's a trip the other day and you know you have to wake up early anyways, you don't get sleep. So I tried to sleep at 12 o'clock or something like that. I was like, okay, no, but I want to put my iPad down and I just want to try and get some sleep. But I did not for a while, and then I just like, I think I slept. So I slept for like 2 hours, I'm assuming. And then by 2:30 again, my mom came in the room to like start getting everything ready. I woke up around 2:45, 2:50. And now it's almost 4 and we're ready and we're ready to leave. So we are going to Tadoba for the jungle safari. So Tadoba is a very, very popular place that is known for its jungle safaris. And we have heard so much about it. So many of our friends, relatives and all have gone there. I've heard so much about it on YouTube, I've seen videos, so I really wanted to go there. And I told my dad around 2 months ago that we should just see, and he checked out the dates and everything and we got a booking for today. And we are going to do 3 or 4 safaris, something like that. So we have to go to Nagpur, and then from Nagpur it's a couple of hours away. I think it's a long drive, around 3 hours. So first we have to go to Nagpur, and then from there the car comes and takes us to Tadoba. So now, let me see y'all at the airport. This is the traffic in Mumbai at 4 a.m. in the morning. Unbelievable. We have reached the airport. It's 4:30, it's around 4:30, 4:35. Done with the check-in, done with everything. I think our boarding starts at around 5:20, if I'm not wrong. So we have a long time. I'm just sitting. My mom's here. My dad's there. My mom and my dad are twinning in a white shirt, and they will not tell me. So I'm not winning. We have reached the Nagpur airport now. We have reached the Nagpur airport now. It is around 7:45, waiting for our luggage and then a drive to the resort at Tadoba. We are finally about to reach now, and it's like, it was almost a 3 hour long car ride. I was sleeping pretty much through and through. So I finally took the camera to vlog. And also the one catch here is that I cannot take my phone while I'm in the safari. We're not allowed to take our phones. We're not allowed to take our phones inside because there have been certain incidents that have happened in the past where people have used the flash and so like that. Have just been incidents that have happened wherein people have not used their phones carefully in front of wild animals. and that has caused a huge stir. So that's why we can't take the phone inside. So we have a camera through which I'll click pictures. I won't be able to vlog inside, but of course the entire journey, etc., I will vlog. We've reached and we're walking towards our room now. So basically we're going for the afternoon safari that starts at 2:30 and it goes up until 7:30 or something like that. So it's like a 4-hour safari. 3 to 7 something. So it's a 4-hour safari basically. And then there's the morning safari as well tomorrow again, which starts at 5:30 and ends at 9:30. So there are the morning and the afternoon / evening safari that are there here. So it is known for the Royal Bengal tigers, and I really am looking forward to seeing tigers because this place is known for that. My father is vlogging me while I vlog. So this place is really known for that, to see the tigers. But again, other than that, there's so much more, right? So many more animals, birds, just like the nature to explore here. I think that's what I'm really looking forward to. So of course, seeing the Royal Bengal tigers, that'll be like a highlight. But again, everything else will also be as interesting and beautiful.
Oh God, look at this. It looks like a snake, oh my God. And now let me give you all a room tour. Let's come again.
So, entering the room now. It's a very, very cute room. It's super, super cute. Here is like, there are two washrooms here. And there's another one here. There's like the bathing area mostly. And then we enter. So cute, a small bed here. There's a table and there's a, like a proper bed here. There's also like a small area here. And look at this. So our room is called the Bison Camp, and that's why this picture, so nice. And then as we go outside, here is like the entire, so it's like we're in the middle of the forest. Everything here is like pure nature, and there's a seating area here as well outside. And let me show all the coolest part. This is the coolest part. Here is another bed, and that's going to be my bed. So you walk up these stairs and then there's like a bed here. So cute. Let's walk up. Not walked before, and the stairs look a little scary, but let's walk up. These definitely look a little scary to walk up on, but it's worth it for this cute little corner. So here is the area on top, very cute. So we're here for lunch now. I actually went to the swimming pool as well, but it was too crowded. There were too many people, so I couldn't swim. Came back up, rested for a while. Now here for lunch. It's too hot here. It's crazy. It was fine in the morning, but then it became crazy hot again. It is worse than Mumbai. It is so bad. Like, you can't stand outside. It's like the heat almost like burns you. It's the burning heat. So now we have to go for a safari as well. I'm really scared because I have a tendency to get giddy and dizzy. So we're gonna have Electral and go, but let's have lunch.
I think it's nice. The cheese and pineapple. Fresh salad. Kachi beer.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
And leaving for safari number one, wearing a cute Friday like my outfit. I was feeling a little tired because of the heat, but better now. On our way to the safari, carried Electral, which is very important. So if y'all are planning to come here, especially during the summers, do get Electral, because it can get very, very hot and you have to be out for around 3 to 4 hours, so it's always better. And I might not be able to vlog from here on because we won't be allowed to use our phones. So when I do come back from the safari, which will be much later in the night, I'll tell y'all if I did see the tiger and what all animals I saw and what all I explored and experienced. It's 5 a.m. the next morning now. I know I would come back and tell you all what I saw, but I saw a tiger yesterday. I saw so much. I saw spotted deers, then a sambar, many, many animals actually. And the tour guide, and there was like a naturalist with us as well that my dad had booked. So he told us so much. He told us so much about the information for these animals. He told us about poaching as well, and how poaching has actually come down quite a lot in the last few years, because the locals have actually understood the importance of tigers. And how, to be very honest, the tiger is actually helping feed so many households. So many people are getting a revenue because people come here to see the tiger. Sometimes you do see, sometimes you don't, but people are getting that revenue, the guides, the naturalists, everybody.
We've just taken a break. We're in the jungle and we're a little outside, so that's why I've taken the camera to vlog inside. No vlogging, no, we don't even touch the phone. There's no internet also, so you do not touch your phone at all, as there's no permission. But today has been not such a good safari day. We haven't seen a lot of animals. We didn't see a tiger, but we saw the spotted deer, a bison also, a sambar. I'll show you all a few pictures on the camera and yesterday's videos as well.
Look guys, here is the tiger that we spotted. This is called Kolarwali, and she was in the water for around, I would say, 2 hours, but we waited, we showed that kind of patience, and then finally she came out and we got a full look of her. So majestic and amazing. Just look at this. So, so, so good. And she's also pregnant. And it was pretty hot, so she was just in the water. This is the Indian gore. It's like around 800 to like 1200 kilos, so super heavy.
But these animals are so calm. I mean, even if there's a jeep, etc., so we are in like a gypsy, even if it's nearby, they do not do anything. They're so calm. They'll just look at you and they'll do their own thing, because even they know that people are quite harmless.
Here are some pictures. And this was the part where we were like really struggling because of all the roots of the trees. There's a particular tree that is quite low in height and it's got like pokey elements, so that's why we were sort of bending to protect ourselves from it. It was quite adventurous.
The resort has given us such a cute little cub, so cute.
So I'm back in my room after the morning safari. My face and my halat is not that great because when you're in the safari, your hair are just like all messed up, right? Because it's so windy and plus like the trees and everything, so it's not possible to look all good after it. One tip: tie a pony or tie a bun and go for a safari. Try to wear like fuller clothes. I wore a sleeveless and it's not good because the tree, the branches of the trees can just, they do hit you. A branch hit me and it like I got a scratch, so it's better to wear full sleeve. And also, you know, so when we went for the safari, I saw that the people in my gypsy, like the jeep, if anyone threw a bottle of plastic bottle of water, they would pick it up, and that's so, so good. So whenever, if y'all have ever gone to safari or y'all do go to a safari, never ever litter around or throw plastic, because it is the animal's home and we are going to their home. So they are not coming into our house, we are going to see them. So it's very important to make sure that we do not disturb them in any form, do not do anything wrong that will harm them. Tigress, who was pregnant, oh my god, we waited for like 2-3 hours just to see her get outside the pond that she was sitting in. Patience is key, guy. And they told the entire story of how tigers live their lives and how there's like the male lion, tiger, and he then mates with the female, the tigress, and when he wants to expand his territory, he will find more such tigresses that he can expand his territory. And then it's his job to keep protecting those 2-3 tigresses who he has mated with and has cubs and kids with. And if he cannot protect them, then the tigress might just find a new tiger to mate with and then to have cubs with, so that he can protect her. He also saw so many beautiful birds. The spotted deers were the cutest. Oh my god, so beautiful. They almost seem like the reindeer of Santa Claus. It's just so nice to keep your phone away and to be in the moment. It's okay to not get a few shots here and there, but as long as you're in the moment, what harm, right? I don't think I'll vlog more. Today is the safari, then tomorrow the entire day we didn't get a safari, so it's free, and then evening we leave again. So I'm gonna go have breakfast and then continue the rest of this trip. So I hope y'all enjoyed it, and if y'all did, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel.